Welcome to the second lesson on the backflow algorithm. In this lesson, we will create a priority list using the backflow algorithm and version 2 of the critical path algorithm, and then we'll create a schedule. This video does assume you're already familiar with the backflow algorithm given in these steps here, as well as here. So let's go ahead and take a look at our example. We want to use the backflow algorithm to create a priority list for the digraph below, then create a schedule. So we're going to work away from the end to the beginning, listing the critical times from each vertex. So we start at the end, which would have a critical time of 0, and notice how task 7, 8, and 9 lead to the end, and therefore the critical time for task 7 would be 11 hours. The time it takes to complete that task. The critical time for task 8 would be 4, the time it takes to complete that task. And then finally, the critical time for task 9 would be 12, the time it takes to complete that task. Now working our way toward the left, if we consider, let's say, task 4, notice how there are two paths to consider. We want the path that has the largest critical time. So if we come from this direction, the critical time would be 11 plus 10 or 21 hours. If we come from this direction, the critical time would be 4 hours plus 10 hours or 14 hours. And since 21 is larger, we'll use the value of 21 for the critical time from task 4. Now looking at task 5 using this path, the critical time would be 11 hours plus 2 hours or 13 hours. Going down here to task 6, the critical time would be 12 hours plus 11 hours or 23 hours. And now looking at task 3, which takes 2 hours, the critical time would be 23 plus 2 or 25, I'll call it hours. Looking at task 2, again we have to consider two paths coming from this direction. The critical time would be 13 plus 2 or 15 hours, but from this direction it would be 21 plus 2 or 23 hours. So we use the larger, which is 23. And then finally looking at task 1, the last task, again we must consider two paths. From this direction, the critical time would be 21 plus 10 or 31 hours. From this direction, it would be 13 plus 10 or 23 hours. So we'll use 31. And now we create our priority list, listing the tasks with the largest critical time to the lowest critical time. Notice that means task 1 would be first, followed by task 3, which would be second. Notice that task 2 and 6 have the same critical time, so we typically list the lowest task number first, so we list task 2 and then task 6, and so on. Now to save some time, I've already listed these out. You may want to pause the video to verify you get the same priority list that I have here. Now that we have our priority list, we'll use the list processing algorithm to create a schedule. And we'll have two processors, so we'll call this processor 1 and this processor 2. We first circle the ready tasks, which would be task 1, 2, and 3. So 1, 3, and 2. Task 1 has the highest priority, so we assign task 1 to processor 1. Task 1 takes 10 hours. We now mark task 1 as in progress, and now we assign task 3 to processor 2. Task 3 takes 2 hours. Task 3 is in progress. After 2 hours, task 3 is complete, so we mark task 3 as complete. Notice how when task 3 is complete, now task 6 is ready. Notice task 5 is not ready because there are other prerequisite tasks. Task 2 is the highest priority ready task, so we assign this to processor 2. Task 2 takes 2 hours. Task 2 is now in progress. Notice at time 4 hours, task 2 is complete. So if task 2 is complete, we do not have any new ready tasks. And therefore, task 6 is assigned to processor 2. Task 6 takes 11 hours, so 4 plus 11 is 15. Task 6 is now in progress. After 10 hours, task 1 is complete. So if task 1 is complete, notice how now we have some new ready tasks. Now task 4 is ready, and so is task 5. Task 4 is the highest priority ready task. Task 4 is assigned to processor 1. Task 4 takes 10 hours, so 10 plus 10 would be 20. Task 4 is now in progress. And after 15 hours, task 6 is complete. Notice there are no new ready tasks, and therefore task 5 is assigned to processor 2. Task 5 takes 2 hours. 15 plus 2 would be 17. Task 5 is in progress. At time 17 hours, task 5 is complete. Which means now task 9 is ready. And task 9 is assigned to processor 2. Task 9 takes 12 hours. So we're at 17 hours plus 12 hours, that'd be 29 hours. Task 9 is in progress. At time 20 hours, task 4 is complete. So here's task 4. When task 4 is complete, we have two new ready tasks. Task 7 is ready, and so is task 8. And therefore, task 7 is assigned to processor 1. Task 7 takes 11 hours, so 20 plus 11, that's 31. Task 7 is now in progress. And at time 29 hours, task 9 is complete. The only unassigned task that's also ready is task 8. And therefore, task 8 is assigned to processor 2. Task 8 takes 4 hours. So 29 plus 4 is 33. Now that all the tasks have been assigned, the schedule is complete. Notice if we continue, at 31 hours, task 7 becomes complete. And after 33 hours, task 8 is complete. And the project is done. Looking at our schedule, notice how processor 1 is idle from 31 hours to 33 hours, the time it takes to complete the entire project. And here's a look at the same schedule created by software. It should be noted that the critical path algorithm doesn't always create the most efficient schedule. In most cases, the critical path algorithm will lead to a very good schedule. However, there are cases where it will not. Unfortunately, there is no known algorithm to always produce the optimal schedule. I hope you found this lesson helpful.